Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. I'm back in London again. I am here for a few things. Crave Beauty has just launched in the UK exclusively at Cult Beauty. So I was here to see Leah, really quickly attend a Cult Beauty event, which I only got the invite for as I was traveling into London. So I managed to free up an hour for that. Then tonight, I'm filming this like different and I keep forgetting what the camera is. Tonight I have a meet and greet with Susan Yara and Naturium, so that'll be fun. Then I go home tomorrow, but I've been here a few days already. So I thought I'd take an opportunity to kind of do some skincare related content, have a bit of a chat about things and just kind of show my getting ready process. My skin is dry London. My skin hates London water. I don't know how I lived here for 8 years and my skin didn't suffer because like the tip of my nose is so dry. My cheeks are really dry. So this routine is gonna be a little bit extra hydrating more than I would usually do. Just kind of put my skin back in a good position. So yes, where are all my products? Here, but they're everywhere, I don't understand. Okay, here we go. So yeah, as I mentioned, I thought I'd do some skincare content. I know that sounds really weird, but I feel like it's been a while since I've done any real dedicated skincare content. You know, obviously I used to do a lot of product reviews, a lot of brand reviews, you know, and I still do them. This is the Mixune Bifida Toner, by the way. I've been loving this just for that extra dose of hydration. And the Bifida Ferment Filtrate is what you find in all those like expensive essences at like £100. But this is super affordable. I'm just gonna do another layer of this because I am extra dry and feeling tight and dehydrated. I just wanna talk about this because I get a lot of comments regarding the more commentary style content I've been doing recently. You know, it kind of started with Instagram versus reality years ago, I think back before the pandemic. And then I started doing When Beauty Turns Ugly. And that's because I still love skincare. Don't get me wrong, I will forever talk about skincare. I love it and be interested and fascinated by it. But I feel like we all know, you know, not just influencers, but everyone included, we kind of all know what our skin likes, what it doesn't like. And I feel like we've all spent like 3 years learning all about skincare. Like there's not much more to talk about. Not necessarily a bad thing, but I also think it's become like a huge consumer issue as well. Obviously, consumerism is an issue amongst all genres and all categories of beauty. But skincare makes less sense to me. I think with makeup, at least, you know, you buy these palettes and you've got like a longer shelf life on them. You can use them all the time, daily, do different looks, then create content out of them. You could use them, you know, they're like coloring pencils. Skincare, you only need so much. And I don't think us skinfluencers, I don't think the purpose of us reviewing skincare was us to be like, you need everything, you need to buy everything we talk about. It's more the sense that we're reviewing products so you don't have to keep buying all of them. We kind of tell you our personal opinions, so hopefully it can give you an idea of what you want to buy. But it's turned into like this mass consumer thing. This is the Muihood Teo Rice Water Essence with prickly pear and snow mushroom, two of my favorite ingredients, really nicely hydrating. A little bit difficult to get out the packaging. And I feel that too. Like my skincare collection has gone from being on, you know, a whole room dedicated to just storing my skincare in my studio to literally being three drawers in a unit of drawers in a different room. Because I'm honestly, it's embarrassing. It's so embarrassing having that much skincare that even as a content creator, you're not gonna have a good amount of time to review or even get to reviewing. And I'll be honest, I like receiving it so I can make up my mind about it, try it, then give it to a friend or family. A lot of it goes to charities as well. I always courier like two big bags worth of product into London for certain charities because I'm just never gonna get round to using it. And I feel like being one of the early day skinfluencers before we were even called skinfluencers, I don't think I ever saw the skincare world going in this direction. Influencer world, I should say. Which is fine, I don't hate it, I also don't love it. So my thought process with the more commentary style stuff is, but also, yeah, so people are less interested in it too. And I think the views kind of show that. And I think as a business, we are businesses legally, tax-wise, we are businesses. We have to keep up with what works. We have people to pay. We have people who rely on our income to give them income. So we have to keep up with what's popular and what are getting views, which is a good indication. And engagement length is a good indication of what people actually enjoy watching. So the commentary stuff has done very well in that regard. And I feel like we get to enjoy it because it's still beauty related and we're all here for beauty related stuff. So, you know, and I still will use skincare. I feel like TikTok is going to be where I kind of offload a lot of reviews or ideas about skincare and all that kind of stuff. When I, what am I doing next? Essence. Oh, I need to do a sheet mask now. So when I first started, did I bring an eye cream? So I wouldn't usually use this many products, but my skin is suffering. So I just want to load it with hydration for now to get me through the events. And then I'll sort it out when I get home. I haven't got the right stuff for me. This is the Cicapair Tiger Grass Repair Serum. Yeah, so my inspiration for the When Beauty Turns Ugly series was this YouTuber. Well, it's a mix of like a YouTuber and a TV program from Paramount Plus, I think it is. That was called When Mega Structures Go Wrong. And there's a YouTuber who I love watching who does videos about how things like, you know, like massive bridges and shopping centers and all these buildings, like how they were poorly made and they all collapsed. And I was like, you know, I can do this with beauty. Like I can do this with skincare. There's so many like lawsuits and tales. I'll just take something I'm interested in and put a beauty spin on it. Okay, I'm going to do a sheet mask yet. This is a Chinese brand. There's a skincare shop here in London that I've shopped from ever since I actually got into K-beauty and Japanese skincare called P2B Us, which is Proud to Be Us. And I popped in there with Robert and found these Chinese sheet masks. So I'm just going to do a little sheet mask just to add some surface level hydration to my skin for now. But yeah, so that's where that comes from. And people have asked me in the comments, like, why, you know, people be like, oh, I miss your product reviews, blah, blah, blah. And to be honest with you, it's because they don't do as well. They don't bring in the views, the money. And obviously money is important because I'm a business. And as I mentioned, I have staff and all that kind of stuff. But views are a good indication of what my audience are actually enjoying and what they're not. So yeah, I just kind of stick to what does well, really. So yeah, I just used one of their sheet masks in that TikTok and my experiment avant-garde reusable sheet mask. I know it kind of like defeats the purpose of having a reusable sheet mask, but it just keeps the mask on my face. I'm now gonna go steam my clothing, so I need the sheet mask to stand there. But yeah, I feel like YouTube has very much become like people's TV, and TikTok is the new kind of like social media platform that everyone goes to. Like personally, I love a longer skincare review, but I think a lot of people are like, if I can get a review in 15 seconds on TikTok, why wouldn't I? So right, I'm gonna go give this 10 minutes and then I'll be back. Okay, so it's been a few minutes. Let's take this off. I really want to try some more Chinese beauty because I think they are really, again, my philosophy when it comes to skincare. I feel like they've got it down, right, with their makeup brands. It's all pretty to look at, but it's really amazing, effective products. And I think a lot of people as well think that Chinese beauty is all tested on animals when it's not. That's not their regulation. And obviously those regulations are changing for the better, but that's a whole other deep dive video that I'm working on, but it's so tough because I want to get the right voices in, kind of like the truth about cruelty-free beauty, which is obviously really important. Like we all want our products to be cruelty-free, but there's a lot of misunderstanding, even amongst the people who think, you know, they know everything there is to know about the cruelty-free laws. It's not as black and white as a lot of people make it sound. So I have been posting more on TikTok recently. I haven't been hating it. I've also not, it's just a platform that I need to get used to. But I'll be honest with you, I struggle posting anything on TikTok. Because usually, you know, when you're on YouTube, you can look at what other people are doing and get some inspiration from it. But when I go over to TikTok, like skincare TikTok especially, it's all stuff we were talking about 5 years ago on YouTube. And I really struggle to bring myself to discuss all that again. Like, again? It's like, why are we talking about this again? And it's just like, it's like these circulating like myths and techniques and like the 10-step Korean skincare routine is just going viral there again. The 7 skin method. So they're calling the 7 toner method now, and that's going viral again. I just don't have the patience for it. I also don't think my audience are on there. Obviously, as YouTubers, we can see our age demographics, and I'm definitely more of a 25 to 35 kind of demographic. And then my next demographic is actually older, so 35 plus. And then not too dissimilar to 25 under. So, but I just feel like my demographic, let me know what you think. We just prefer longer reviews and longer form content. I personally don't want to hear a 20-year-old talk about how what they're doing with their skin. Maybe I do. I follow a few 20-year-olds. What was that? What did I just use? Oh, I used the Ilyune Ceramide Atto Soothing Gel. Full disclosure, I've done a sponsorship with Ilyune once before, but that's because I love their products. I'm pretty sure they do. My other favorite, like, barrier soothing cream is the Astura Atto Barrier Soothing Cream. Soothing cream? Or Atto Barrier Cream. I'm pretty sure they're the same products. Or, like, the same technology. But yeah, you like, get either or, you love them. So I am going to use a skin tint, but I'm going to go in with the Fix On Primer Hydro from, I don't know, Code or something. This is like a really hydrating serum, but it's actually a primer. No, contact lenses. But yeah, I feel like I don't quite get how TikTok works. I don't know if I want to, but I will. I'll keep posting. But you know, the cadence and the rhythm and all that kind of stuff, I just don't. I know I mentioned that this is like a routine for my dry skin, but this is also pretty much a standard routine for when I'm going out somewhere, just to have like a more natural dewy glow. I'm gonna wear these ones from Moody Lens. They're just like a brownish kind of gold color. So they're gonna make my eyes just look like a little bit bigger, a little bit rounder. I also find when I do meet and greets and I'm like talking to people, they look at my eyes more when I wear color contacts. And I like eye contact if that's something they're comfortable with too. Excuse my watery eyes though, I hate anything near my eyes. But yeah, this is the Fix On Primer Hydro from Code something, I can't remember the brand. This is just like a super quenching, hydrating primer that just, I don't know, I don't know how to talk about makeup. But I feel like whenever I wear like a skin tint or even just like a tinted sunscreen, it kind of adds that extra staying power for the tint. Concentrate on the tip of my nose because it's so dry and red. I also feel like I've been sick for like a month. Not like really bad, but I just feel like I've been exhausted. Like I feel fine now, but for a good 3 weeks, I just felt exhausted. Like I had a sore throat every single day. Like it just felt nonstop. But yeah, I feel like a lot of us are in a bit of a rut at the moment. Definitely not burnt out. I love doing like the research for all these videos. I'm trying a few different editing styles now as well. And I love doing that. But I just feel like I'm in a bit of a rut. Like I just want something else to do. Not instead of YouTube. I hate when creators just like leave YouTube and then come back and expect everything to be like normal again. I'm using the Summer Fridays tint. I'm not going to show you the bottle because it is embarrassing. I will put it up here, but it's grubby as hell. This is just such a nice like sheer tint that just kind of like evens out like a little bit of rosacea for me. But yeah, I just feel like I want like another project to do, another something, you know? But the thing is with YouTube is you just don't have time. You have to be very consistent with uploads. Otherwise YouTube's like, well, everyone hates you now. When I took a break at Christmas, my AdSense went down by nearly 50%. 50%, can you imagine any other job where they're like, oh, if you take a week off, we're gonna half your paycheck at the end of the month. Isn't that crazy? So people was like, oh, why are you always working? I feel like this is, you know, in every job, time is money, but I feel like this is one of the only jobs where the employee can directly see that time equals money. And if you're not putting all your time into it, you are losing money. I'll still pick it over any other job I've ever done. Every job has their pros and cons, but at least we get to do our own thing and on our own time. And anyone who's complaining about it, I think maybe they're too young and haven't worked a real job a day in their life. They don't have much to compare it to. I like that. It's very natural. I like how you can still see a bit of redness in my skin because I feel like my skin without any redness doesn't have any dimension. Okay, I'm gonna go do my hair, then I'll be back. Okay, I think I'm done. I think that's it now. I think I'm ready to go. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Oh no, eyebrows. I'm gonna use the Milk Kush Gel. It's a clear eyebrow gel, I don't know. It doesn't really do too much for my brows, but it definitely keeps them in a little bit of shape. They're so thick that they just kind of do what they want. So it's nice to add a little bit of tidiness to them. But yeah, to follow on the conversation of like YouTube and stuff, I've been trying a few different editing styles that I've heard or like seen, you know, multiple different editing styles, sorry, that is meant to help with engagement, basically keep the video interesting. So like halfway through, you're not like, okay, I'm bored now, and you switch off. So let me know if there's anything you like or dislike in the editing styles, because I will be trying different things. Yeah, that's it really, let me know. So is my hair supposed to look like that? It always looks different on camera than it does in the mirror. versus a car reflection window. Interesting choice. But yes, there we go. Right, I am off to Westfield, White City, Space NK with Naturium. Hopefully I'm going to see a few of you there. If not, I'll see you some other time. I'm sure we'll do more meet and greets. Thanks for watching. You can watch some other videos here. It's in general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.